Mic check. 1, 2, 1, 2. Microphone check. Off. 1, 2, 1, 2.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for coming.
I know that you have been intimidated so much. And I know that you would have been very many people to welcome us today. But I want to thank those of you that have come here today. Many of you had to swim to come here. Many of you had to go through terrible roads to come here. So for you that have come here, you are the real heroes of this generation. My name is Kyagulanyi Ssentamu Robert. Welcome that you're giving us
today.
Many of you last saw me when I was a Rastaman with very long hair. And many of you last saw me in the videos or on stage when I'm a musician. But today I bring a very serious message. And I want to ask you to listen to me very carefully. And after listening to me, I want to ask those of you that have come here today to take the message and make sure everybody gets this message. Because this is a very serious message. Many days the police and the military have stopped me from talking to the people of Northern Uganda. Because they know that when I talk to you, your eyes will open and you will see what I see and you will know what I know. But today in the morning I went to church and I prayed to God. And I want to tell you, my brothers and sisters, that the Almighty God is powerful. Because Museveni does not want me to come here to talk to you. Museveni is very scared of what I am telling you. So I want to ask some of you who are friends, please record what I am telling you. And if you don't have a phone or a recorder, please record it in your head. And those that are making noise, please keep quiet for only a few minutes because what I'm telling you is very important. Many of you are younger than me. And yet even me, I was only 4 years when Museveni was taking over our country.
That was in 1986.
35
years ago. And since then he has made us slaves in our own land.
The
elders, that are here today, they know what I am talking about. But for you, the young ones, you were born in slavery. And they are trying to tell you that it is okay to be slave. But I am here to announce the end of slavery. I am here to tell you that we are going to be free. Listen to me very carefully. You see this land where you live? It is a very, very rich land. It is a very rich land. But you, the people that live here, you are very, very poor. Why? Because Museveni made it his property and the property of his family. Let me tell you, my brothers and sisters, one day I was just a young ghetto boy like that Rasta boy. And because of the music that I was singing for you, you supported me, and I traveled the whole world, and I saw that countries that don't have even a quarter of what we have, they are richer than us. Do you know that in 1962 we were on the same level with Singapore? Do you know that most of the schools and the hospitals were built either in Amin or Bote's government? Because we are not even sure that he's a Ugandan. Many of our fathers and mothers, many of them have died in poverty. And now, for us, we don't have a future. Many young people are unemployed. Look at the roads where we travel on. Look at the hospitals where we take our wives to give birth. Look at the schools where we take our children. Look at the place where we are right now. This is supposed to be a bus park. I want to tell you, how many people have ever seen a bus here? Is a land so rich in natural resources. This is a land with very intelligent people. But because we don't have a president, we have a thief. That is why we find ourselves in this situation. Now I want you to take this very, very serious. Because when you read the law,
Kono chikti Uganda.
Article number one of our constitution says.
Chura chelme chikwame Uganda.
That all power belongs to the people. Now take this one even more serious. That we have an opportunity to change this once and for all. And that is why I came from wherever I came from. And that is why I came from wherever I came from to come and represent you. That is why I'm standing to be the next president of Uganda. I am not here to represent the rich people. I am not here to represent the city people. I am here to represent the poor people. To represent the common people. To represent the village people. To represent the farmers. To represent the women that are dying every day in the hospitals. To represent the children whose future has been stolen away. I am here to represent the ghetto people.